Hello and welcome to another video unboxing for the Cool Kingdom YouTube channel, and today we are taking a look at the brand new Battles of Legend Relentless Revenge set, which just came out for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Trading Card Game. So some really cool stuff in here, some interesting reprints actually, and there's obviously the new Fairy Tale stuff as well as the Gumblar Dragons, so some very, very cool stuff in here, and well worth taking a look at. So we're going to dive straight into this box. It is one of these sort of foil sets where you get 5 foil cards in every pack. So that's 4 supers and 1 secret. It's generally the style that Konami likes to go with. So let's just pop open this case. And you can see, as per usual, it sits upright into the display mode. And then we have 24 packs in here. So we'll take a look at one side first, and then we'll move on to the second side. So let's just focus this in a little bit better. So starting off with an ultra-rare Torrential Tribute. Great to get this rarity bump for any of you guys playing the common version already. Then we have Ultra Halon the Time Lord, Dark Lord Contact, Psyframe Driver, really nice to get this as a reprint, and we have a Trickstar Reincarnation, the Secret Rare actually, so really, really cool to see this reprinted very soon after actually it became a popular deck, so it looks like we're getting Ultras and Secrets within the set, which is quite nice to be able to have. So that's our first secret. What would be really nice is to be able to pull a playset of Reincarnations from this, actually. Then we have a Kaki, the United Unity Star, Iron Cage, Rainbow Dark Dragon, that's really cool to see, Windrose, the Elemental Lord, and a Glyph, the Phantom Bird, so this is for your Fairy Tale archetype, which I believe was a key part in the TV series. Then we have Foolish Burial Goods, getting a lot of reprints these days. Litmus Doom Swordsman. Solemn Strike, that's really nice as a reprint actually as well. TG Wonder Magician, potentially hinting that we'll be getting Needle Fiber soon. And Living Fossil here, that's pretty cool too. Then we have Michion the Time Lord, or Michion. A Trickstar Narcissus, a Summon Dice, Kaiki the Unity Star, and Metal Foes Mithrilium, a really awesome looking printing of this card. Not particularly popular at the moment, but it looks absolutely phenomenal, definitely worth picking this guy up. Then we have a Cyber Lava, a Shura the Combat Star, a Cyber Dragon, Cyber Eltonin, and Glass Slippers, another part of the Fairy Tale Ensemble. So the current the majority of the Fairy Tale cards are focused kind of on the Cinderella story, so they all fit into that. Then we have a Driver, Eater of Millions, Dark Lord Enchantment, a Beguska, that's really cool to get an Ultra actually, and Golden Castle of Stromberg, so the key field spell for the Fairy Tale archetype. Looks really impressive in Secret Rare, completely Golden Castle, Blue Sky, great combination, and definitely absolutely crucial for the deck. It's really cool to see that. Then we have a reprint of Naruto, that's cool. Pumpkin Carriage, Cephalon, the Ultimate Time Lord. Solemn Judgment as an Ultra, that's pretty awesome. And a Dark Lord Ixchel, so getting a reprint in Secret Rare still, again. So we'll see what happens with the value of this card. It's really important for the deck, and great to have another printing of it, actually. This pack doesn't seem to want to open. Excuse me, it was the others, but we got it. So we have a reprinted Damage Juggler, a Kyoto Waterfront, Altergeist Hextia, with the correct wording in here, I believe, Dark Lord Contact, And Empty Machine, this is pretty interesting. So this, again, goes with the Time Lord archetype. Time Lords are pretty interesting. They require a lot of setup, but once they get it, they have a surprising amount of capability once they have achieved that. Iron Knight, this goes with the Fairy Tail archetype, actually really important for the generic engine that the deck involves. Slash Roar, which was promoted for its really crazy crazy OTKs and FTKs that you can do with this kind of thing. Well, OTKs with this specifically. Then we have an Iron Hands, again goes with the Iron Knight, that's really nice. Represented Gaia Saber, that's pretty cool actually. And number 75, a Bamboozling Gossip Shadow. This is pretty awesome. So this is 2 plus level 3 monsters. Let's take a quick look at the effect here. So once per turn, when an opponent's monster activates its effect, quick effect, you can detach 2 materials from this card. The activated effect becomes both players draw 1 card. You can target 1 other number Xyz monster you control, attach this card to it as a material, transfer its materials to that monster. You can only use the effect of number 75, Bamboozling Gossip Shadow, once per turn. So a rank 3 with 2600 defense, that's pretty massive, already beating Dante there. And then bamboozling your opponent by making their effects just basically draw 1, that's pretty cool. Then we have another Cyber Eltonin, Litmus Doom Swordsman, the Kaiju Files, so a lot of Kaiju reprints here, another Burial Goods, and a Phantom Knights of Ancient Cloak. So Phantom Knights getting some cool reprints in here as well, to go with our rank 3 Bamboozling, that's pretty cool. Then Noble Knights Medrot, that's pretty nice to see. Cyber Lava, Full Metal Foes Alkahest, another Hextia, and a Gamma Seal, the Sea Turtle Kaiju in Secret Rare. This is awesome to get as a reprint because obviously it's the most most prominent Kaiju, probably the most famous and most well-known, most used, and getting it as a secret just really, really nice to have because obviously it was just a rare beforehand. I believe pretty much everything in the deck was a rare beforehand. Now you can pick it up all in Ultras and Secrets, that's pretty nice. Then we have a Noble Knight Brothers. Unending Nightmare, this is cool because obviously it was just the secret beforehand. Another Iron Hands, another Solemn Judgment, and a Silent Boots as a secret as well. Really cool. So basically the set is boosting up all the rarities of your previous cards. We've got some really awesome stuff already from the set, but it'll be interesting to see what we get from the second half of the box. So moving on to the second half, we start off with another Solemn Strike, Iron Cage, Banishment of the Dark Lords, so your Searcher, I believe, a Kaiju Files, and a Crystron Quandax. So again, another of the better options that you can bring out with your Needle Fiber once it becomes playable within TCG regions. It's really nice to see Konami just sort of arming players with useful tools for the future. Sendai on here, Summon Dice, Imduk, the World Chalice Dragon, that's a cool reprint. Eater of Millions, and Monster Reborn in Secret, this is gorgeous. Definitely worth picking this guy up. Absolutely awesome to get this original artwork, Monster Reborn in Secret Rare. Obviously not the OCG artwork version, so you can pick that up at specific stores and specific conditions, otherwise you'll have to be looking online for that. Then we have a Performage Trick Clown, Born from Draconis. Neospecian Grand Moor reprint, obviously after it came off the ban list, that's pretty hyped. Noble Knight, Brothers, and Dragonic Diagram, again printed as a secret, but still looking absolutely awesome there. And good to get that reprint for all the True Draco players. Then we have a Kyoto Waterfront, Unizombie, a TG Wonder Magician, a Raphael on the Time Lord, and Card Trooper as a secret. This is pretty interesting. I don't think there are many decks that actually go for Card Trooper at the moment. So it'll be interesting to see if there's anything in the future that could potentially use this a little bit more. And in the meantime, it's very nice to have a secret rare version of the card. Then another Medrot, Hayate, the Earthstar, Duelist Alliance, World Legacy's Heart, and Cyber Emergence there. I believe this is new. This is adding a Light Machine monster, so again, basically additional Cyber Dragon support. There's a lot of Cyber Dragon support due to drop within the next few months, so well worth picking up anything that you think might be useful for that deck. Dark Lord Naston, a Trick Clown, Bottomless Trap Hole, an Iron Knight, and a Boral Guard Dragon. So this is pretty awesome. So 3+ effect monsters cannot be destroyed by card effects. Once per turn, you can send one card from your spell and trap zone to the graveyard. Special summon from either graveyard to your field one monster that was destroyed and sent there this turn, but its effects are negated. Once per turn, quick effect, you can target one monster from the field. Change it to face-up defense position. Your opponent cannot activate cards or effects in response to this card. This effect's activation. So really, really nice utility. Another sort of just fairly generic Link 4 with 3,000 attack. Again, you do need to fight monsters, but really nice to see. So I wonder if we're going to be able to get a Gumbler Dragon from the cover into this video. So we have a Unizombie, another Beguska, Banishment, Altergeist Manifestation with the updated wording here, and a Prince's Inn. So this is the Cinderella. They've gone with Prince's Inn. Interesting name. This is essentially what enables a lot of the typical fairy tale plays that are supposed to be built into the deck to play, although you can just basically go with the Iron Hands, Iron Knight plays instead as a more generic engine. This card is kind of ridiculous in what you get out of it, so it's really cool to see this actually. Then we have a Metion, Convert Contact, a Pyrex, the Elemental Lords, the reprints of all of the Elemental Lords recently, actually. And then another Windrose here. And number 67, Paradise Smasher. This card was pretty interesting. As soon as they released it, it sounded pretty awesome. Obviously, a dice, die roll effect. So there's a fair amount of luck involved, but it's really cool to see. Then we have a Neospatian Aqua Dolphin, a Slash Draw, Tenma the Sky Star, Idaten the Conqueror Star, and another Quandax. Another Duelist Alliance, another Manifestation, a Litmus Doom Ritual, we used to summon up the Doom Swordsman, a Cyber Dragon, and Infinite Light. So another one of these that goes with your Time Lords. This goes with the other trap, the Infinite Machine, I believe. And then for our penultimate pack, we have an Air Hummingbird, another Naruto, Unending Nightmare, Born from Draconis, and another Secret Rare Gamseal. This looks absolutely awesome still. So well worth picking up. And for the final pack, can we actually get any of the cover cards? I don't think we've got any of them so far. Okay, so we have Gaia Saber, the Lightning Shadow, World Legacy Discovery, Gabrion, the Time Lord, Pumpkin Carriage, and Glorious Numbers. We did not get any of the cover cards in this video, but we got some really, really awesome stuff. Potentially we've got even better stuff out of the set, some fantastic looking secrets within this. I gotta say, I absolutely love the reprint of Gamseal in Secret, the reprint of Monster Reborn in Secret. These cards look absolutely phenomenal. Getting the Borogard Dragon was actually really awesome from the set. It's a fantastic, fairly generic Link monster, well worth trying out. And checking out in the future. And so this has been the Core Kingdom unboxing of the Battles of Legend Relentless Revenge. Feel free to check out our link in the description down below. You can head over to our website in order to pick up your own box of Battles of Legend. We'll also be uploading the option to pick up any of the individual single cards from the set, or you can just check out our website for picking up booster packs, singles, decks, all that kind of stuff. With special coupons that allow you to reduce the price of every item that you buy based on how much you're buying. So be sure to apply all of those coupons when you go to checkout. That will save you a lot of money in your purchases. Thanks for watching this video, and hopefully we'll see you guys in the next one.